Hello, Ranos here, and welcome to episode of Cosmoteer, where we're going to be going against two of Severus Terrace's ships. But for now, we'll be going against Showstopper, which is kind of like in the game, and although you may know there's been an update, which had some new parts, which I may actually update these missile ships, because, you know, them being the slowest, it may be a good idea to put on the new thruster, which is a really big one. We'll put on the thruster booster, and yes, this is actually quite laggy. I sent them all over there. Yeah, the new thruster might actually help it gain a lot more speed. And also has thrusters that face multiple directions as well. They're only like the smallest ones, so it's more for maneuverability than anything else, but it could be good. And oh my, the lag. Well, as soon as Showstopper starts going down, it stands no chance. Well, this may take a while. Considering the distance. So I'll be right back. And we're very close. It seems like Showstopper seems to be approaching. And that ship literally sticks to its name. It's lagging me so badly. Nee. Well, as soon as they get close enough to start targeting one, well, as soon as he starts targeting my ships, then that'd be good. Though it's going even slower because I just selected every single reactor as a target and weapon. That's why it's going even slower. So as parts get destroyed, it should speed up. Who knows? Okay, they're approaching. Has he detected me? Is he able to detect me? Pretty sure he's got a sensor array on there somewhere. The fact he's attacking my ships right now suggests that he doesn't have a sensor array. Huh. Interesting. Oh, there we go. Targeting now. However, Showstopper isn't very maneuverable. Probably why I got completely destroyed by my heavy support units. And again, there were 50 of them, so. Though, oddly enough, it did better against 100. Oh well. Come on, get closer. Yeah, my ships are trying to maintain formation. Oh well. Showstopper will start approaching at some point because it does want to take out my ships. Ah, bugger. Oh, it's going straight from a missile ship. What a bugger. Okay, soon the lasers and bullets will start to fly. Well, Capri is actually getting quite close. And thing is, Showstopper also has a lot of missiles on it, so let's see how that goes. But most of its bulk is thrusters, so I'm not sure if my fleet will be able to get through. Well, I'll be able to destroy its weapons pretty quickly. Oh, there's some cannon fire flying. Yeah. Melting the front end. Damages have been received. Missiles are flying from both ships. Unfortunately, due to heavy lag, just how bad the damages are on any of the ships yet. Well, Capri is taking some damage to the side. The missiles on Showstopper have already been partly destroyed. Yeah, it's lost quite a few weapons on its left side already. Oh, it seems like Sheritar's took some damage. Both missile ships, Namakar and Volokar, seem to be unharmed at the moment. Oh my. Melting right through it with those lasers. Oh my. Sheritar needs a bit of assistance there. Oh, lots of its weapons on the front are gone. This laser's going to cause an issue, though. Okay, let's pause it so we can assess the damages so far. Oh wow, that's quite a bit of damage, plus a bit of fire. Oh! Well, that's one thing I never put into there. Oops. It appears the missile ships are still unharmed. Ouchie. It's lost quite a lot of its weapons. In fact, this side's only got two missile launchers left. You haven't taken any damage by the looks of it. No, wait, you got a bit of damage over here. And you're unharmed. Okay. Let's focus on Showstopper and see how much more destruction comes its way. Quite noisy, too. Oh my. All of its side is losing lots of thrusters now on one side. Oh, probably. Oh, Nemecar's getting lasered. Oh, that's not good. It's losing a lot of itself quite quickly, though. Especially with its missile launcher being bombarded by so many more missiles than what it can handle. Ouchie, that's bad damage on Calvaria there. Oh, they need to put out those fires quickly before it spreads too far. Oh, the Shurotar is breaking off from the group a bit. And Nemecar is taking quite a few hits there. Those lasers. But as soon as Calvaria can get through to his lasers, then it should be fine. That's going to be easier said than done. Quite a few missile defenses on the back. And as you can already tell, we've got some more frames. And I just realised something. I don't. Yeah, I kind of noticed that it was being split into 2 minute segments. Whoops. Forgot to change settings from when I was playing Okami. Oh well. Oh my. Nemecar's taking on some heavy hits from that laser. Luckily, Calvaria's trying to get all the way through to its laser. Oh, there's another set of lasers gone. That's not good. But he is getting through to their lasers. He's almost hit the reactors that's powering them. So Nemecar should soon be saved. Okay, they've lost almost all their missiles, so soon he'll have no offensive capabilities. Come on, Nemecar, get yourself out of there. Oh god, the front of Nemecar's almost gone. Blimey. What's the boiler car doing all the way up there? Well, destroying the missiles by the looks of it. Okay. Ooh, there goes some reactors for one of its thruster sets. Now, that thing does not like Nemecar, does it? I find the amusing thing is that they're both using the same missile layout. Oh wait, no, it's using something different. Yeah, still got three missile factories with for two launchers. Oh my, those three lasers are still causing problems. Well, it looks like it won't have any missiles soon. How much these repairs are going to cost me? Probably quite a bit. Blimey. There's not a lot left of this bugger, is there? And soon, there'll be a lot of some more reactors there. Man, that guy does not like Nemecar. Oh well, let's zoom out a bit. Let's probably slow it down by quite a bit. Volokar, what are you doing? You're meant to be in this battle, not floating all the way over there. You do, Ghostar. Yeah, I can't do anything about breaking the formation now. It seems like only a few ships are in battle right now. Ooh, big part just came off. Lasers can't actually hit a target. How unfortunate for it. I Seems like even a great behemoth like Showstopper has no chance against my fleet. Oh well. Well, we do have another ship to take a look at in a moment. And what's going on? I'm just floating off for some reason. Yeah, I think its main control system is being taken offline. Ooh, all those missiles from Namakar. Fun Volar car! Jeez, they're all too fussy about staying in formation. Well, okay then. It appears Showstopper has been destroyed. Just a few fires still left to finish it off. So how much is that going to cost me? Huh, not even a million. And all that stuff needs to be powered up. And how about the other side, take that out. Finish it off. Here we have Malboro, another one of Severus Terrace's ships. According to what he said, you need to strike it from two... Well, if one side gets destroyed, it will just simply flip around to attack from the other side. Which is quite an interesting concept. You can definitely tell it's mirrored, and all its thrusters are on the inside. Well, I guess that puts a lot more space for armor and weapons. But anyway, let's switch it to player 2 and to AI normal, and let's bring my fleet in to attack it. Okay, they're in range. Now that should definitely attack mine, well, target mine quite early because it has 4 sensor arrays on it. So it should start changing its target soon. But let's see. Yep, it's targeting now. Now let's see, which ship will be the victorious ones? Then again, this is a single ship versus 5 equally sized ones. Oh, but they're not as heavily armed as that one. That's the only downfall of my ships. They're not very good at one-on-one combat because they're not heavily armed themselves. Mainly because they were designed to work in a group. It's kind of a design problem I keep coming up with. I keep designing things that can't really deal with things one-on-one. They always need support from another ship. Well, other ships with stuff. Ooh, the front of that ship's going. Oh my. It's just rolling around to take damage on all sides now. Ouch. All those missiles coming around as well. Why is it trying to laser Calpurnia? I don't know, they always have to one of the supports or missile ships. They don't have to Calpurnia. And again, I guess they're programmed to get rid of the smallest ship. Or one of the smaller ones. So it is a good strategy. Get rid of a tiny one so you can focus more energy on the bigger ones. And you take less damage. Oh well. All things being annihilated. And it's been split into 2 parts. Destroy it! Not much of it left. And boom. There's just a few reactors left in that one. And it looks like my fleet was able to take out both these ships. But this one taking a very minuscule amount of damage. Oh well, never mind. So if you guys would like to see my ships take on something else, or even another fleet, or even your own ships, then just leave a comment either down below here or on the Cosmoteer chat on my Discord server. On my Discord server, you're also going to be able to share your ships for mine to battle against. So that could be fun. But anyway, I'm going to end this one here, and I hope you all enjoyed this video. If you have, please leave a like and even subscribe for more episodes. Then I shall see you all next time. Bye-bye.